works at the end of a string of four. You can find most of my art as it goes live. When it's posted. With that in mind, I can probably actually pop in. Maybe you let me know if anything is suggested on your end. And we're in. As per usual, if anything is suggested, like I just said, just let me know in the chat. I do have eyes there. If you are painting alongside me or even just hanging out, make sure that you have snacks, a drink, that you have space to stretch if need be. You want to take care of this body that you've been given, you will only get one. So we will hop in. We're gonna hop into the shading as per the title. Oh, I do have that. Yes, I do. Awesome. Okay, but no, this is not what we're here to do. We're here to... Let me make sure. I've actually grown kind of used to... okay, no. Well, actually... And thankfully these shoes are really close to each other. In terms of shading, I don't have to do too much finagling. How has everyone's day been? I did just get up, but yesterday I felt very productive. Doing some life stuff that I needed to do. I also did some prep for my D&D sessions. For my D&D session this coming Sunday, which I'm definitely looking forward to. The first session went off really well. So I would happily take that. Felt really good with how it went. And I got good feedback from my players. So that is how yesterday went. I did some prep, I did some real life work. Today I might do some after stream. Do some Stardew Valley. Every once in a while I try to take like a few days off a game. Because I'll spend like 3 hours playing it. And I do want to make sure that I'm not completely getting lost in it. This is 3. And then we'll do this. I do wish I could remember the name of the song, but that's alright. Alright, as an anime enthusiast, I might end up switching background music just because I think this might get somewhat distracting. But that's alright. I think most of us have had our time watching anime, and if you're not, I wonder what rock you've been living under. That's okay. There we go. Oh, FMA, right? FMA. That's my guess. I'll check out in a minute. Because I can. Yeah, it is. That's the good thing. That's actually, I think, what I kind of enjoy about the setup that I have at the moment. And then we will... just go into a lighter blue. Now let's down this to 30. Probably don't need it to be that bright, so. We're just gonna create that shape. We again aren't really going to reach into this territory where my mouse is at the moment. Are my anime enthusiasts at though? I am. Where are we at? Awesome. Okay. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Today, I actually made significant progress on the other piece that I'm working on, and I'm pretty pleased with how that went, how it's gone. I've basically finished all the skin shading on it, and started on the hair, which definitely not have gone better. It looks really, really good, especially compared to the fact that, like, I'm currently a little bit more critique-y about hair shading, which is generally not as fun, but also very good for, like, upping your skill, which, of course, not everyone has to have that goal in the art world, but I happen to have that and want to get better. This tool smaller. And we'll go right over. And let me. Now, so I am going to clean that up a little bit. I might pop in with an even darker shade of blue. Might go to two on that one. No, actually, I might go into one. This is already going to look so good. It's a little bit less precise than I normally would, but given that this is also not going to be part that you zoom in on, I'm not as worried about getting it perfect. There we go. Let's blend it. Wait, am I blending with too big of a tool? I think I might be. I think I might just be. Awesome. Here we go. We will get this now. Awesome. That is already worlds better than what I was doing. Thank heck. Awesome. Already better. Oh, I did not crack my neck beforehand properly. I cracked, like, the one side. That caught me by surprise. Ow. It's, like, not even in a really ow sort of way. I just felt the air pop. So we got that one cleaned up. Yeah, it's not much in the way of, like, notating the difference, but it does the job. I could, if I want to, go, like, something like this, if I want, which I might do in a moment, but first we're gonna pop in and do the shoe tongue first. Now, laces are one thing that, like, there's some things that I will call the devil. Hands. Mostly. Feet. Basically, extremities. Laces? No. Laces just are not happening. I'm willing to paint hands. I am willing to paint feet. I am not willing to do laces again. I used to try it. But it looked so interesting that I am just not, at least or as of right now, not interested in trying them again. Akin to just leaving them out of the painting, effectively. Now, let's make this 45 and see what happens. Yeah, that'll do it. That do it. Well, let's see. There we go. All right. Because this is already not supposed to be happening. There we go. Okay. Awesome. Let's create that arch. And let's double up on this. And then we'll go into opacity 30 just to create this shape again. And not as far out this time. We do want to create that, like, shape of, like, a shoe that's being worn. So that's what we're doing. There we go. And of course this will mean a little bit more cleanup, if I haven't done it totally right, but that's alright, I'm okay with that. And just like that, have that shape in the shoe, which is what I was going for. Success. Hell yeah. Without too much fuss. Which is how you want to do it. Awesome. There we go. Awesome. I like that better already now. So let's save that, and then we can go on to the next tool, the next part. Okay, so first I'm gonna, like, so now that we're onto the shorts, which is up here, we are going to have to fight that. This right here. And that's going to be the last of our worries. We're going to handle that last. We're going to shade in everything else. And then that's going to be it. Okay, now we don't need it. Okay, let's... I think I can probably make that a little bit lighter still and still get the point across. Yes. Okay. Awesome. That's what we want. Okay. So first, we want to get that, and we want to get the pockets. We want to make sure that we're actually in the shape of those pockets, that they feel pretty solidly real. And do that on the same side here. Awesome. Let's get this. Awesome. Now, I'm not 100% solid on how that's going to end up working with the shape, but that's okay. Now, let's hop this into 45 gear. That's what I'm calling it right now. I like this tool. For that, we immediately have the ability to tell that that is 3D-esque, which is what we want. Okay. And then come across that 45. As I said, we will be giving more depth into, like, under those laces, probably on another layer, but we want to get the base of the shorts first. Awesome, okay. Now let's... do this, all the way up to here, and then on another round, we will be downing that to 30, so we can actually create that shape of the moving 3D-esque shorts. Awesome. Okay. Now that we have that, we bring that down to 30. And we turn this up to 15 size tool. Which is about what you need to make it to show that difference, anyways. And then we will go from there. I am a little unsure of how to handle this like tool. This like with the in terms of sort of creating that depth, just because this is so large a space, and I don't want to leave too much of it like untouched and unblended and unshaded, but that's all right. We'll figure it out. Awesome. Okay. And now you break out of that into that same opacity. Ooh, no, we can do lighter than that. We can do a little darker than that. Still get that point across. I can actually still get even darker than that. We're not really gonna worry about it up there either. Except maybe on those like pockets. I'm gonna take it to this size tool. Awesome. Now we can actually break out the blending tool and start. I'm gonna start with the pockets at least. That requires the least amount of specific attention. And once we get this knocked out of the way, then we can probably be a little bit more reckless in the shader. Which is kind of what I want to be able to do. Awesome. Have that blended out. Now let's blend out the top. I'm going to make that a size 10. Shall we? Yes. Not an intense shade, which is not because it's not what we want anyways. We are sort of adding it in there. Just doing a little bit of that shading. Now we can actually go a little bit more all out with that 20 size tool. Nope, 30 size tool. Just a little bit more fit to this. Yeah, already you can see that coming together. Exactly the way we want it. Now, with those like bright spots in the middle where that lighting is going to be, we're just going to really soften that up by blending it out a lot. Just like that. Awesome. Just like that. Just like that, we have our shading there. What I might do, and probably then, no, actually what I need to do now is actually pop back in with those, with that 2, set it to 90 again, let me pop right back in, we'll clean up all that blending in a moment. Only once we've done this first. Which means I might want to make this a size 1 tool. It might still be a little small, but that's alright. We can make it work. Awesome. And again, because of where it is, I'm not really all that worried about creasing of the pocket. I'm considering doing a little bit of shading there, but I'm not all that worried. Just like this. Awesome. This is what I would call the depth color. What I might do with this is I might put it to 45 and put it here. Still sort of there, but much less intense than it is out there. Just to sort of know for a fact that we're creating that 3D effect. And now we'll hop into 30. Go into size 4 tools. And there we go. Actually, what I can probably do here, this, just to sort of ensure that. then we'll just have to be really careful when we go to clean it up. And then we do that here. And we have all of that. And again, with the laces, we will be doing that on a separate layer. We'll get size 10. Blending tool out. There we go. Alright. And then what I might do, because I don't want to create that shape out here. Well, we'll see what happens when we do. What do you think? No, I think I don't mind that as much as I thought I was going to. So we're probably good. I'm gonna do this. Awesome. And then, sort of shade that. And from here, we can probably actually start to clean it all up now. But we've finally done all that. Mind me fishing with some of my setup real quick. Make sure we're not getting actually in the painting, within the line art, that is. Oh, I never blended in here. Let's fix that. And then, just to see if maybe we can blend that edge out. I'll take it. I will take that blended edge. Awesome. Now we will have to make this tool a little smaller just to get in between the legs. And we'll wash and we'll blend that. There we go. Awesome. Awesome. There we go. Now, just clean up along this bottom ledge. I'm pretty sure it's mostly cleaned up along this side, unless I'm wrong. I don't want to be wrong. I think I was. That's okay. We cleaned it up. We took care of it. And then now we go along this other side, and then we can clean up the rest of the shorts, and then we can focus on those laces. And once we're done the laces, then we're done the shorts. They're basic shorts for me to wear, but I'm literally wearing them right now, and I'm literally wearing a black tank top right now. So I could not have gone with a more accurate representation of my usual outfit. Let me go up and around. Awesome. Awesome. And now, with that, I'm not even gonna name this layer. We're just gonna hop right in. We go to size 1 shading. Ooh, I lost feeling in my foot. Amazing. Alright. So we're going to create this shape here. There we go. We're just gonna make sure that that's there. along this side of it. And then... Oh, I did not do that at the right. That's alright. That's alright. So I'll just make the effect a little bit more potent. And then we do this. Do this. And then we'll do this. Clean. I will blend that out, and then I'll clean it up where the laces are, and that is when I will pop in those pops of color. Or as much color as there can be in this, of course. Make this a size 7 tool, maybe? Okay, and then... Awesome. Now we pop into those laces. We do this. We're not gonna mess with the shading that's on the other layers. Just what's on this one. Awesome. Just like that, have that go for us. Now let's see what happens when we put that 2 size 2 on. I think we maybe need to make that a little bit lighter then. Awesome. And then we do this. And then we leave it at that. Now we pop in with that 4 size blending, which will leave that sort of light shade to pop a little bit more from the actual shorts. This is just the laces that we're talking about. This is the laces we're trying to preserve. Awesome. Now we zoom out. There we go. Yeah, like that. I'm pretty happy with that. I am pretty dang happy with that. Because now we can work on the shirt shading. And then we just have the scarf. We are so close to finishing this piece. I am so happy with this so far. Look at this. Look at this. It looks so good. This is already really, really good. Okay. Now, so let's hop back into this. And we are going to get into the right tool preset. Oh yeah, that'll do. That'll definitely do. Maybe you could do a little bit lighter than that. I think we want to before we add in the depth. Yeah. A little darker, right? There. Yeah. Now we'll just go around the shape of the chest the first time. And then we'll go from there. Once we have this shape in, we can actually hop in with those 45s and bigger size tools. And go from there. Because from here, now we can actually hop in with that 45, like I just said. With that 5. Which is already significantly better. And again, I'm actually going to add a little bit of this. Because that's the shape, kind of shape we want. Especially with the way light is often going to reflect. So we're just going to create this shape. and go under. And then you'll actually hop into that size 10 or size 8 perhaps. And go around. Go around on the side now. Just to make sure we're creating that sort of 3D shape. This is not just flat coloring, this is coming off the page. Awesome, just like that. And then I'll hop up here. We actually have this sort of gradient going on. And hop into that 30, go into the size 15, and we're actually going to do that there too, just to sort of create that effect that we're looking for. And then we will run that along the side too. And if I was concerned about there not being enough, like, shading to remind us that there's, like, shape to the shorts, that also applies to the tank top, which is why we're absolutely going to be adding some of that depth back in. But for now, we're just going to be adding a little bit of that in here. It'll definitely mean some cleanup for me, but that's all right. Awesome. How are we feeling about that? And so now we can hop back in here with that 45, right? How does that 45 look like? There we go. Yeah, that absolutely works. Okay, so now let's make that a 25 size tool. Create that shape there. And now we bring this out. Now I bring out these big guns. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now we have that basic shape of that basic 3D effect that we're just gonna enhance a little bit more and clean up a lot. But first, let's round out this bit of lighting. There we go. It's not perfectly obvious, but we still create that. We still have that sort of depth. Awesome. 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 Let's sort of connect that of happening right there. Okay, so now we have a base of like what that shading looks like. Time to hop right into that black, that deep, deep black. 290. Size 2 tools. Gosh, we are just going right back in with this. And then we'll hop back in with that 30, that same shape we sort of created the first time. This layer is definitely going to require some cleanup. That is a-okay. Awesome. Because we're not totally worried about, I think I can probably have a little bit of fun with this. Awesome. And now we hop into 30. Just so I know what that looks like. Alright. And we bring that to size 10. And we do this. I'm gonna do this. Or again, just going to make sure that you can really see the shadow from the scarf. Awesome. Just like that, I am already really pleased with this. Like, I am a-okay. A-okay with this. Yes. Just like that. And then I will hop along those sides again. To get that shape once more. And then we can probably safely blend again. I might even want to, maybe if I make this smaller, do this. That being the qualifier. And then we can probably add a little bit of that lighting. It's a little too late. Too late on a lot of that. But it can still create that dimension, that shape. Okay, so now that we have that, let's use a more reasonably sized tool. And then we go from there. And then we'll blend and blend and blend until all of this sort of meshes to create the shape we're hoping for. Because the closer we get to under the chest, the more we want to sort of focus in that blending tool a little bit. Follow. And I think I'm okay where that is anyways. Okay, so let's run this out just a little bit more. Awesome. We still get that shape of that light hitting. That up being totally invasive. Awesome. Alright, and now we're going to hop into that 5 tool, 5 size blending. Definitely just refusing to give, to leave too much give. Not sure I can go anywhere smaller than a 10, unfortunately, which is the annoying bit, because this is what I really want to highlight. Do, 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 do. kind of doing what I wanted to. Not quite, but kind of. Let's try it this way. Might be just because of how small and tight that corner is. I think that might be solid. I think that might be where as much as I can blend that. And then maybe I bring that 30 tool into play here so that it like looks a little bit more natural when this gets blended in. Awesome, just like that. Just like that. Now we clean up and then we really see how I feel about this. This is definitely could have been worse. Awesome. Let's up the side. It is past the 45 mark when I would normally have started to do a stretch and indicated it's time for you to do the same, but I will just stretch that out after the stream. You're at a pretty solid point, and I am good to keep going for now. Awesome. Just like that. Awesome. There we go. And we up and around here. I'm already, like, very pleased because it's very hard to make a tank top interesting. You know what I mean? It's very, very hard to make a tank top an interesting part of a painting. But I think, all things considered, what I have to work with, this has come out pretty good. There we go. That's fine. It's fine. Awesome. Let's awesome. There we go. Now, I still need to clean up towards the bottom, but this is a pretty good picture of what this is effectively going to look like at the end piece. Shading at the bottom, all of that beautifully shaded. And then we just have the scarf to paint to shade. Then on, I will either work on it on my own because it then goes into text territory. But we'll go from there. Alright, now we're gonna save real quick before we lose that progress. Is there anything I need to clean up here? No. Ooh. Now we have scarf shading. Now let's hop into this and see what we're cooking with. Okay, so that's barely gonna make a difference. Let's turn that down a little bit. Let's up the opacity to 90 first. Yeah, let's already set to work. Let's set to work. And then we set on that. We're gonna do the scarf chunk by chunk. because this is an entirely different shade than the other bit, which is meant to be white, but because our hair is currently split dye like Todoroki, accidental, but not, we're not complaining about it, you know what I mean? So that is what this is meant to mimic. There we go. Now let's go all around. Now we have that. And then let's hop into the 30. Make that a size 6 tool. First, and then there we go. And now we hop into a brighter red. I mean, let that shine a little bit. We go from there. Oh boy, too big. Too big of a blending tool. Are trying to make sure it's sort of smooth though, so it does do the job all right. There we go, yep. All right, so with that in mind, let's pop in. Probably actually don't need to do as much darker shading on this in terms of depth. I'm still going to, just in case, though. Yeah. The one thing about anime, for us, we watch a lot of it for dates with our partner systems. One of our partner systems. Very prone to getting like fictives. Some of these, like, we're very familiar with some of these intro tunes. Not a complaint, but yeah, it is something we do keep in mind sometimes. We're very familiar with some of these tunes because some of them are very like. I want to watch more of my source, which is not something all fictives want, but like some of our fictives do. Awesome, okay. And then we'll just clean up around the edge of this bit. I think I have something on my screen. Got it. And then we'll go from there to the other part of the scarf. Awesome. Already, this is gorgeous. Now, one thing that I neglected to add to this is sort of bits of like shading and bits where like the scarf sort of dips. As you can see, there's like folds in this. I did not add that, which is what I'm going to do. Okay. Now, we're actually going to bring that all the way down here. There we go. I think what I'll do is we'll do this and then we'll just double size this, make that a 4 size, and we go from there. A little depth in between. It's not going to be a perfect scarf, but I think with scarves, something I get a lot of practice doing is being sort of patient about it. For example, I'm definitely 100% going to need to come back in with more of that shading. Sort of denote that this is like a blended scarf. So I'm going to get a different, hopefully darker, oh boy, 99. Alright, will that do the job? Oh, that'll definitely do the job. But I can probably make this tool a lot smaller. By a lot smaller, I mean the only indication smaller than what's already there. Awesome. Let's go. And then we go into 30. And then we do this. Not the whole, so we're not doing the whole thing. We are very much putting that indentation in there. Make that a size tool. Tool size 6. Let's see what happens. Oh, okay, sure. My brain just recognized the background music. Like, I keep having a hard time telling if it's from Hunter x Hunter, or if it's from FMIB. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. How am I feeling about that? I think I want to, like, blend that out a little bit more. I think it's a little bit too, like, you can obviously see this, which is what I was mostly hoping would come out of that. Could probably blend this out a little bit more. Make it out a size 10, maybe? Probably doesn't need to be blended out that much, but, it still keeps that demarcation. Of like, this is a folded piece of cloth, which I will take. We're gonna save this painting, and then I probably don't need to, but just in case, let's run that eraser tool along that side. Awesome. So now let's got a 58, I want to say. That is the awesome. Okay, I am actually going to save this here and then end the stream here because beyond putting the little sidebar, I'm not entirely sure what else to do in terms of painting. This will be posted on Twitter, on Tumblr, when it's done, so keep an eye out for that. There we go. So, as per usual, this will be up on my YouTube as a VOD, so feel free to check it out. There. Top link. Clockwork System on YouTube. The one under that is Clockwork Sys, which is our Instagram, and then our Twitter is clockwork_sys. If you have game suggestions or if you've been painting alongside me and would like to show me what you've been working on, it is welcome. I am definitely like curious in what people make while they're painting alongside me or watching, because that's kind of what this is for, hoping to sort of spur on some creativity. I hope everyone has had a lovely day. I hope you have a lovely rest of the week. I will see you Friday, and I hope you're having a good one.